Thank you, Mr Deputy Speaker. I wanted to raise tonight a subject of which the local impact is difficult to fully assess, but nevertheless constantly affects our community. The reach of homelessness extends far into all of our communities, some seen and some unseen. There are a number of factors that cause people to end up in this situation, and at all levels of government, local, state and federal, we are constantly working to try and address these issues. Indeed, it is one I'm trying to currently work on across the political spectrum and across levels of government locally since the closure of the local service City Life. In Dunkley, many local organisations work to address the needs of those to whom accommodation and food is unavailable for whatever reason, such as, for example, schools like John Paul College as well. Steve Phillips and the team at Community Support Frankston also do an absolutely amazing job in supporting some of the most vulnerable people in Frankston and surrounds. CSF is one of the busiest agencies of its type in Victoria, with nearly 13,000 people contacting the organisation for assistance last year. They are a not-for-profit community support agency about to celebrate 50 years, which provide services including emergency food, grocery vouchers, help with utility bills, referrals and advocacy for people who live or work in the city of Frankston. The agency helps to provide people with information, advice and skills so they gain the ability to make more effective life choices within their community. They have approximately 80 volunteer community workers from a wide range of social, political, religious, cultural and work backgrounds who provide their time and services free of charge and have been doing so, as I said, for 50 years. Community Support Frankston have found in recent years that the demand for their services has dramatically increased. The Stronger Communities program round from 2016 provided them with $15,000 of federal funding for additional storage for the increase in donations they were receiving. The 2017 round will fund for them a shelter to provide a weather-protected area for food deliveries and also provide food to those who need it. The level of support within the community for these critical services is fantastic. And as regrettable as is the need for these assets, together we are working to lower the degree of need in Dunkley. Treasurer Scott Morrison also visited CSF when in Frankston and is aware of the funding reductions that occurred in the years prior to my election. I am fighting for restoration of this important funding for CSF. LifeGate is another organisation who do important work. Reverend Angel and Pastor Uli Rolden work to equip and empower individuals and families to overcome crises such as drug and alcohol addictions and other life-controlling problems, suicidal tendencies, abuse, broken relationships and depression, and ultimately to fulfil their full potential in life. LifeGate have recently acquired a specially designed and appropriately fitted out barbecue trailer with running water, slide-out barbecue that will replace their makeshift food van. I was pleased the federal government and I were able to help their Meals for Change project, providing $10,000 of federal funding through the Stronger Communities program. Family Life also received a grant under the recent round of the Stronger Communities program funding, worth $10,000 of federal funding, for their Family Relationship Centre facilities. These kind of services are critical in preventing or addressing family breakdowns, working to mitigate the risks posed to some of our more vulnerable members of our community. With a very similar focus, Mr Deputy Speaker, just recently the Turnbull government provided $117 million over 5 years to 102 ReConnect services across Australia, including the Salvation Army's Peninsula Youth and Family Services. ReConnect provides support and assistance to young people who are homeless or at risk of homelessness, working to address many of the concerns before vulnerable young people in Dunkley find themselves in situations that escalate to the point that they have no support and accommodation. The Salvo's Youth and Family Services on the Mornington Peninsula will provide counselling, family mediation and practical support to find accommodation for young people and their families. And on that point, I must also mention the work of Fusion, who operate from the former Belcombe Army Barracks and support young people in my electorate, but also in the neighbouring electorate of the Minister for Health, the member for Flinders. By keeping people at risk of homelessness connected with their families, communities, education and employment opportunities, we can work to prevent people falling into homelessness. But ultimately, some people do fall through the cracks, and it is good to know that when they do, there are many services and concerned residents who are able to help.